Hi, I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with episode 29 of Do More with R, Send a Slack Message Right from Your R Script. Using R to send a Slack message may sound like a parlor trick, but there are actually a lot of cases where that could come in handy. I've used it to send graphs to colleagues with latest web analytics trends. You can also use it to notify yourself or others when a lengthy R script has finished running. Bob Root has created an R package that makes it easy to send Slack messages with R. It's called SlackR, and it's on CRAN, so you can install it with install.packages and then load it as usual with library. The most complicated part of this by far is initial setup. Fortunately, you only need to do that once on your system. Let's go through it step by step. You'll need to authorize R to use your specific Slack. Bob shows a sample configuration file to do this in the following format. So we need an API token, and we need an incoming webhook URL. Slack's developer documentation for this can be tough to find. It turns out that you first want to create a new Slack app in whatever Slack you want to message. So go to api.slack.com/apps. That would be here. Click that green Create an App button. Name it something. Do More with R App. And I'd like it to be in my More with R Slack. I'll create the app. Next, select incoming webhooks, and then click the button to activate them. Finally, scroll down and add a new webhook. You'll be asked which channel you want to use it for. But don't worry, you can override that. You don't need a new webhook for each channel. That's just a default. Pick one and then click install. Now copy that new webhook URL into your R Slack configuration file. And I'll save that. We also need an API token. A Slack legacy token works fine for this. Slack will show you many warnings advising you not to use them, but they do work. Here's how to get one. Go to api.slack.com/custom-integrations/legacy-tokens. You can see that URL here. You should see your Slack workspace listed. Click the Create Token button. I already have a token, so the button doesn't appear. Now copy that token and pop it into your configuration file. And save. Note I'll be regenerating both my webhook and my API token after I've put it on screen for everyone to see. But for now, Slack setup is done. Next up is configuring SlackR to use this authorization file. That part is more straightforward. Just run the SlackR_setup function. SlackR setup defaults to expecting a file named .slackr in your home directory. If you want to use another file in another location, add its name, including full file path if it's not in your working directory, to SlackR setup. You can see here I'm using a file called .morewithr_slack. I'll run that now. And you'll need to run SlackR_setup at the start of each session when you're using SlackR. Finally, the fun part. I have a simple text message including my current system date and time saved to this variable my_message. To send it to Slack, I run the Slacker_message function. The first argument here is the message text, and the second argument is the channel I want to send to. Notice the channel name has a pound sign in front of it. All right, let's get that. Let's send that. And let's check Slack. And there it is. If you want to send someone a private message, set the channel to their Slack name with an @ sign in front of it, like I did here. I'm sending this to myself. And there it is. It's also easy to send an image file with the Slacker_upload command. As I did last episode on sending email from R, I'll create a graph of monthly US unemployment and save it to the file unemployment_graph.png. Okay, that's not the important part. I just need a break from using empty cars and iris data to test on. Next here, I'll send a text message like I did before. Here I'm saving this to a variable. And I send the text message. We should see that here. There's the new text message. Next is the file upload. Here my first argument is the name of the file. Next argument is a little headline for the file. And here are the channels. You can do more than one channel. I'm just doing one here. I'd like to upload it to. Let's wait for that to show up. And there you have it, Slack messages from R. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at go.infoworld.com/morewithR, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on the YouTube IDG Tech Talk channel. Hope to see you next episode.